Today, I'm going to show you how to speed up your Unreal blueprinting and reduce code duplication with custom reusable blueprint components. We're going to create a simple health system that uses a reusable blueprint component that we can add to any actor that can take damage. In my blueprints folder, I'm going to create an actor component blueprint, and I'm going to name it health component. I'm going to create a float variable for health and max health. And I'm going to set health equal to max health at the beginning of play. I'm also going to make max health instance editable so designers can easily assign different maximum health for different actors. And I'm going to give it a default value so it doesn't default to zero. I also want to save a reference to the actor that is using our component, and I'll use the getOwner node to do that right after we've set our starting health. I want to bind a custom event to the actor's onTakeAnyDamage event. I'm going to name the custom event takeDamage. In our custom event, we want to set the health equal to health minus damage. We don't want the health to ever go above max health or below zero, so we should also clamp this value when we make the change. This is also the perfect opportunity to detect if health has dropped to zero. But our code for handling death doesn't belong in our health component. We want different actors to do different things when their health reaches zero. For example, a player character should die and a red barrel should explode. Our health component doesn't know if it's owned by a player character or a barrel, and it doesn't need to know its owner's class thanks to the power of interfaces. Our component only needs to know that it is owned by an actor that can do something when its health reaches zero. And interfaces are a way to promise things that a class can do. I'm going to create a blueprint interface, and I'm going to name it iHealth. My iHealth interface is going to have a single event named onHealthDepleted, because I want anything that has health to be able to do something when its health reaches zero. Now that the interface exists, we can finish writing our health component. In our health component, we want to get the owner and call its onHealthDepleted event. The last thing we need to do is implement our iHealth interface inside of our actor. Open your actor and go to Class Settings. Under Interfaces, click the Add dropdown and search for iHealth. Right-click on the onHealthDepleted function and choose Implement Event to implement the function as an event. And this is where our death code goes. If you're going to destroy your actor, save that instruction for last. And if you find yourself writing the same code to handle death in multiple blueprints, stop repeating yourself and turn that into a reusable blueprint component instead. Now that you know how to create components, check out this next video where I explain when and why you should create components.